Philip Markoff is a 23-year-old Boston University medical student. Tall, blonde, good-looking gentleman, look nice. He's by all accounts what we would consider a good citizen. I just said, hi, how are you? And he said, good. I said, all right, come on, and motioned him to follow me into the room. He has no criminal record. He has a fiance. He seems to be an ambitious, intelligent man who had a future ahead of him. I shut the door, I turned around and I locked it. That's when he pulled out the gun. He's very calm, like he's done it before.
I discovered that Philip Markoff did have a secret life, a side of him that his family and friends had no idea existed.
He looked nice, he looked young, good looking, obviously. He picked up a pair of my underwear that were on the floor and put them in his pocket.
It wasn't just about the money. It was, if I'm gonna get the money, how can I get it and fulfill this personal need for thrill?
What frightened a lot of people is these pictures of a person that doesn't seem to have a care in the world, targeting women in nice hotels in a busy part of the city where a lot of tourists hang out. That was a huge concern for police.
So this young man who had everything, he threw it all away, and everyone wants to know why.
It's hard to say why anybody does anything. Only in his heart of hearts does Philip Markoff know why he did what he did.
Markoff was born on February 12, 1986. Markoff attended the State University of New York, University at Albany, where he received a bachelor's degree in biology. Here is where he met Megan McAllister, a senior, also a pre-med student. Once their undergraduates were complete, they moved to Quincy, Massachusetts to attend med school at Boston University. The two were engaged in 2008, and their wedding was to occur on August 14, 2009. Philip Markoff, a second-year med student at Boston University, is found guilty of the murder of Julissa Brisman, a masseuse and call girl who had her services advertised on Craigslist. He was also found guilty of two robberies prior to the murder. He was found dead on August 15, 2010, in his jail cell after committing suicide.
There was physical evidence found inside of the Weston Hotel room crime scene and found on Philip Markoff's body when he was arrested. Inside of the room, Julissa Brisman's body was found face down in the doorway. She had zip ties that bound her hands together, and there were 9mm bullet wounds found in her hip, lung, and heart. Bloodstains were found on the carpet along with a cell phone, a spent bullet casing, and a Gucci bag. Inside of the bag was identification that helped to identify Julissa. The bathroom door contained evidence that Julissa was held captive but escaped. There were zip ties around the doorknob. One end was loose. Out of the entire apartment, there was only one fingerprint found after dusting the room that did not match Julissa's. The other evidence from the hotel is the video footage catch from the security tapes. Videos and images of Philip Markoff entering the hotel were found and also leaving the scene while on his cell phone texting. His fiance, Megan McAllister, continuously said that he was innocent. For reassurance that he was indeed guilty, there was a search of the couple's apartment. This is where physical evidence proved Philip to be guilty. Inside of a hollowed-out copy of Grey's Anatomy, there was a 9mm semi-automatic handgun and a New York State driver's license that was in the name of Andrew Miller. Also, bullets matching those used to kill Julissa were found taped behind the back of the dryer. There were also zip ties, a stash of women's underwear, a black leather jacket, Yankees cap, and a pair of brown leather shoes with Julissa's blood on them. After comparing the fingerprints found in the hotel room and the fingerprints lifted from the grocery store after Philip went shopping at BJ's, it was evident that the fingerprint was indeed from Philip. When he was arrested, there was blood found on both of his shoes. After DNA analysis, it was concluded that the blood was Julissa's. All of this evidence linked Philip Markoff to the murder.
Within a week of the crime, the police had tracked down Philip Markoff, who would soon become known as the Craigslist killer. The police cracked the case through a combination of lucky breaks, good police work, and a trial of traditional and digital forensic evidence. The police got their first clue when they turned on Brisman's phone and found that she had a call from her friend Beth. Beth said that she arranged appointments for Julissa, who was working as a masseuse, for men she met through Craigslist ads. She said that Julissa had a 10 p.m. appointment with a man who went by the name Andy M. Beth gave the police his phone number and email address. The police caught another break when they collected the hotel surveillance of a young man in a black leather jacket and a Yankees hat leaving the hotel around the time of the murder. The police then showed the photos of the man to another masseuse who had been robbed at gunpoint and tied with zip ties in a nearby hotel by a man she met through Craigslist a few days earlier. She positively identified the man in the photos as the man who attacked her. Between the two women, the police figured out the phone numbers used to contact both women were two prepaid disposable phones. The phones were registered to Philip Markov. 2 days after Julissa was killed, another woman working as an exotic dancer was attacked by a man who responded to her ad on Craigslist. This man was positively identified as the man responsible for Brisman's murder. The police turned to Facebook where they came across a wedding page for him and his fiancée, Megan McAllister. After Markov's name was discovered, the police launched a stakeout at Markov's and McAllister's apartment. One day, Markov went to the grocery store. The police followed behind, dusting everything he touched, even the grocery store cart handle to compare the fingerprint they lifted from the first attack. On April 20th, 6 days after Brisman's murder, the police pulled over Markov's car as he was driving to a casino in Connecticut and arrested him.
Although Markov was seen as a clean-cut Boston University med student preparing to marry, it was later discovered through interviews of former classmates and professors that there may have been something wrong mentally with Markov. Former lab partner Tiffany Montgomery stated that she was not surprised with the accusations against Markov. Montgomery claims she suspected he may have been suicidal during his college years and recalls his drastic mood swings as evidence of a problem. She says one day he'd be warm and friendly, and the next day you'd see him upset and brooding. Former high school classmates remembered him as a bully to anyone he thought was beneath him. Markov also had a gambling problem that began as early as high school. Police suspected that gambling debts are what sparked Markov's robberies. Markov's family was completely unaware of what had been going on. They saw Markov as a charming man with a bright future. Markov's fiancé and parents still defend him despite the overwhelming evidence against him. Killings connected to Craigslist have appeared on news sites since 2009, when Philip Markov was arrested. Markov was arrested for the killing of Julissa Brisman and the robbing of another Las Vegas woman in April 2009. There is a list of 58 accused or convicted murderers and 45 murder victims tied to Craigslist since 2009. Each of these crimes stemmed from a Craigslist interaction of some sort, overwhelmingly from robberies gone bad where someone either advertised on Craigslist that he or she had an item to sell and his killer responded to that ad with the intention to rob him or her, but ended up killing them instead, or vice versa. Chelsea Goff, one of the researchers for the report, stated that the Craigslist connections run from these types of robberies gone bad to ads for prostitution, roommate listings, personal ads, and others. Since the arrest in 2009, of Philip Markov, aka the Craigslist killer, the website has faced increased scrutiny by the media.
An autopsy is scheduled today for the so-called Craigslist killer, who apparently committed suicide in a Boston jail Sunday. 24-year-old Philip Markov was awaiting trial for the brutal murder of a masseuse he met online. Our Andrea Canning has more.
The same weekend Philip Markov was found dead in his cell, he should have been celebrating his one-year wedding anniversary. But last year, his fiance called off the engagement after discovering he was the alleged Craigslist killer.
I ask that the defendant be held without bail.
Markov's trial was in less than 8 months, but police sources say he took his own life Sunday by cutting himself repeatedly with a jail-issued razor and suffocating himself with a garbage bag from his cell trash can.
He would not be the kind of person who wanted to face the music, face the trial, be embarrassed and humiliated in public during his trial for first-degree murder.
The former Boston University med student was accused of killing Jaleesa Brisman in April 2009 and was later charged with robbing two other women who advertised exotic services on Craigslist. Last year, he used his shoelaces to try and hang himself and then tried suicide again by running a serrated spoon over his wrists. Markoff maintained his innocence until the end. A spokesperson for the family of Jaleesa Brisman released a statement saying the long-awaited criminal prosecution was their only opportunity to confront him, and now he has taken that away as well. For Good Morning America, Andrea Canning, ABC News.